If you have a bunch of old PCB boards laying around and you're dying to get the components out of it, I'll show you a fast, easy, yet very dangerous way to do it. This process will require working with a molten pot of metal. Proceed at your own risk. Some examples of components I like to salvage are dip sockets, USB connectors, even large capacitors. Resistors, probably not. I purchased a soldering iron that has a sucking option on it and tried to use it on these capacitors. You'd think this would be an easy job. I'd get the soldering iron hot, pop it over the joint, suck it out, and hopefully the component will pop right out. For me, that's never the case. There's always some residual solder left behind where I could never pull the component out. This thing really did suck. Time for plan B. Dip the PCB board in a molten bath of solder and pull the components right out. Tools that you're going to need, of course, some PCB boards, some needle nose pliers, some vise grips, and of course, a shallow pan full of solder. Safety equipment, of course, some safety glasses, gloves, and make sure your little piggies are covered in leather shoes. Notice the cutout in my shallow pan. This lets me put the circuit board in a little bit easier. I bought this pan at a thrift store for like 50 cents. Turn the fire on and let the heat do its magic. It takes about 3 to 5 minutes to melt the solder. If you need to add solder, just dip it in after it's melted. I did have to melt 2 full spools of solder. The new solder will smoke until the core is completely burned, so don't do this inside. Now that the solder's completely melted, let's dip our components in. This is a small PCB board. Large ones you will have to cut. Just dip the PCB board in the molten solder and carefully pull the components out. Try not to drop the components in the melted solder. I'm going to go around one by one pulling components out as I need. You might notice I'm struggling pulling some components out. That's because I bend the pins over on things like dip sockets to keep them from falling out during the soldering process. In many cases, I have to cut my PCB boards so they're small enough to fit in the pan. That way the contacts will make contact with the molten solder. Once you have your components out, time to inspect them to see what can be reused. This dip socket here isn't in too bad a shape, a little dirty, but it does fit right in the PCB board. This dip socket was badly damaged during the removal process. It can't be reused. Some of the USB connectors are in pretty good shape. They might be a little hard to get in, but they're usable. Others, not so much. The buck converter here came out like a snap and goes in like a snap. Small battery holders came out pretty good. This capacitor, even though there's a little bit of grunge on there, is usable. I had to pinch this capacitor a little bit too hard and ruined it. These more expensive components survived the process, so we'll reuse them. Well, that's it. Hopefully this process will help you save some of your electronic components and help you save a few bucks. Just be careful around molten metal.